And welcome back. We're down here on Highway 95 right here at the Bullhead Area Chamber parking lot. And of course, I've got speed switches just every year they're here. How you doing, Jamie?
Good. Nice to meet you.
Good to see
you.
Yep. Nice to meet you. Yeah. Yep. How many times? This is his first time in the trap, so to speak. His brother's usually doing this. Brother's not here today, so you're the man.
Yep, I am.
Yeah.
Back here again, doing the usual dyno tuning and getting ready. We've already done a few bikes today already. So.
Good. Yep. Good. Well, you guys really do get busy by the end of the year. You've got a great following, and I know you make about every bike show there is. The only other bike show I go to is up in Sturgis. I see you there all the time.
Yep, the big day.
And you'll be back there again.
Yep, absolutely. So now we bought a shop in Black Hawk, South Dakota.
Awesome.
And we've got a second dyno trailer there that we do dyno tuning, and then pretty much everything we do on the road, we also do at the shop, except for there we also have machine work and stuff that we can do, so we can take it a step further than we do even on the road.
Well, that's huge, because I think this year they're expecting up to 1.2 million people in Sturgis.
Right.
Shop ought to be a little busy.
Yeah, we're actually going to have both. We'll have our spot down on Lazelle that we normally are at there, across from Shopco Pomida.
Right.
And then we're also going to have the shop open as well. So we'll actually have both dynos going.
Wow.
And both, both areas going, so we can do hopefully a lot more work and service more people.
But in between that, you got to go down to Florida.
In between that, yep. We actually got a few rallies that we got to do before that. We'll do our Panama, Myrtle Beach, Ohio Bike Week, Laconia. We got about another five or six we do before Sturgis.
It's going to make an old man of you. You know that, don't you?
Yeah, pretty much, yep.
One of the things, my bike's running pretty good, so really don't need to get it on the dyno. Why mess with perfection, right? But there's other things you need to think about, especially if you're up here, you've ridden all the way up from, let's say, the coast, you're ready to ride back. Take a look at your oil, see how it is. And if you haven't changed it lately, you've got the perfect idea.
Yeah. Yeah, what we have is we brought a new company on board, Spectral Performance Oils. They actually make oil for S&S Cycle. And then we brought them on board and use all of their products, everything from their mineral oil to their synthetics, primary oil. They have the whole array of everything down to brake cleaner and everything.
So you stand behind this is a good oil?
Absolutely. Yep, they've been in the motorcycle racing for years. And then, like I said, obviously, if they're making S&S stuff, you know that it's good quality.
True story. Now, show them this. This is an oil filter they have made, and I know it's cool, right? Billet aluminum, yep. And of course it acts as a, acts as a cooler too, helps cool it.
Yep.
But it's reusable, you don't have to go buy a new element every time.
Yep, you just clean it out.
Clean that out.
Solvent like brake cleaner or solvent. It's got triple magnets on the end where most of them only have one.
Yep.
It's a stainless steel mesh instead of a paper filter like your standard filter, so it flows seven times that of your standard paper filter. And like you said, you just clean out the cartridge, clean out the insert, drop it back in, lock it in place. Oops, sorry about that. Pull a little oil on your O-ring and spin it on the bike.
About three, 4 years ago I bought mine. I've probably saved $100-$150 in filters already.
Yep. And then the other thing it does do on top of that is it works like an oil cooler as well. It's got fins on it, so as the air passes through, it'll actually drop the temperature of the oil another 4 to 8 degrees. So you're kind of getting two things in one when you're purchasing it.
It's amazing. 15 years ago, everybody says, oh, you don't need to worry about cooling the oil down. Now they finally understand you better darn well cool the oil.
Absolutely.
Every opportunity you have.
Especially down here in an area like in Arizona where you have a lot higher temperatures and
sure.
stuff. Dropping the oil temperature is even more drastic than it is in the other parts of the country.
You guys have a huge air cleaner. I use one on my bike as well.
So we have an air cleaner that we call the Speedy Flow Air Cleaner. It's all billet aluminum, all made in the USA. And it's the filter is a lot wider than most of your other filters.
Yep.
It's about another half inch wider than your standard, say a Screaming Eagle or something like that. A washable, cleanable filter, so it's pretty much you'll have it for a really long time, if not lifetime, depending on how often you ride the bike.
Right.
You can use the stock cover over the outside, or you can use, like we have chrome covers that go on the end. I've even got ones with our logo, or you can buy all different kinds. As long as it's got the center bolt hole, it'll work.
You've also got weather socks for them?
Yep, rain socks that go over the top if you choose to use those. And then the nice thing is, the way everything is designed, it all takes the blow-by, which comes out of the top and goes down through the backing plate and then back into the venturi. Yep, that way you don't get all that oil mess.
Also, everywhere you've got a bolt that goes through, there's a...
Miton O-ring.
Yeah, and it's O-ring, plus you can go ahead and tighten it down. It's
set
got
screw.
The little set screw everywhere on it, so you don't have to worry about everything backing out on you, being driving down the road. and all of a sudden your air cleaner and all the accoutrement laying somewhere on the road.
Exactly.
It's really a very solid, nice unit. Yep. Got one, I've had it for years, and I absolutely love it. Absolutely love it. I've got a lot of your stuff on my bike, as a matter of fact.
Yeah.
You've got the Power Commander, the Dyno Jet.
Yep, Power Commander. Power Commanders and the Dyno Jet. And we also are carrying the Power Vision, and we also tune the Power Vision, which is a little bit different unit than the standard Power Commander. Your Power Commander is a piggyback unit where it actually stays on the bike, and then we change the map based on, you know, the cells that we change.
Oh, okay.
The Power Vision's kind of similar to the TTS unit or the race tuner. It does it by flashing the ECM or recalibrating the ECM.
Okay.
The nice thing about the Power Vision is it actually gives you more capabilities and more things you can do with it than, say, the standard race tuner. Like, you can use it as a scanalyzer, go in, check codes, clear codes.
Right.
I mean, there's just so many things, the list goes on and on and on of what you can do. You can store up to 7 different maps in it.
Wow.
I mean, there's just a whole bunch of stuff. You can actually mount it on the bike, and you can use it as an LCD monitor and show real-time fuel mileage, real-time head temperature. Just the list goes on and on. Depends on how you want to use it.
You're running Rush exhaust now, too,
yep,
I see.
Yep, we picked up Rush exhaust. We did that last year, and I've had them on board. I have really good luck and success with those guys, and they make everything pretty much for every model of bike you can think of.
Right.
I mean, we use mainly the Harley stuff, but we also, you know, do get some of the metrics and some of that stuff, too. But, yeah, I've been really happy with the product, and... they have interchangeable tips, which is nice. So
yeah.
You buy the slip-ons, and then the guy wants a fancy tip to go with it. You can easily interchange them out, which is real nice.
Awesome. Now, also, they do all kinds of engine work here. If you get your bike in soon enough, you need to change your cams out, cam plate, whatever the case may be, or you just want to check and make sure that cam bearings aren't wearing out too badly, you haven't got a bunch of oil in there, bring it in, let them check it out. But you know what? On some of these stock motors, all it takes is a little bit of a cam change, and it will wake them up. It's unbelievable what a 5 1/4 cam will do.
Especially the 103s.
Yeah.
We've got a nice, really nice, good cam for that from S&S called an MR103 cam. It's just a beautiful camshaft to put in that with a nice tune. It'll take the bike from 60-some horse up into that 90-some horse range.
You're kidding.
Yeah, no, it's really, really good. And it'll actually bump the torque up into that 110, 112 for pounds.
Holy criminy.
Yeah. Now, very good camshaft. It's and it's designed just for the 103s too. So
there you have it. You can get all that done. You can get your engine oil changed. You can get your cams changed.
And motors. And even new complete motors.
And right complete motors right here.
Yep. So we got 106 kits. You know, it just depends on 95-inch kits. Just depends on what year of bike and what the customer wants.
Look for them in Hot Bike every month. Got an article in there, and of course they'll be up in Sturgis, but for this weekend, they're right here in Bullhead City at the Bullhead Area Park, Chamber of Commerce Park, right next to the Turtle, as a matter of fact. You know where that is. So stop by and see him, ask him about some of this stuff, and if you need your bike needs to be dynoed, right here's the place to get it done. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Always good seeing you.
You too, buddy.
And we'll see you in Sturgis.
Yes.
Done. We'll be back. There's more.